Following your introduction to the game Stands Online, you must be warned of the risks that lie ahead. That is why this informative video was created in order to teach you the stages of a Stands Online player's life. And with this basic information out of the way, I would like to explain the first stage of a Stands Online player's life. The noob who most likely watched JoJo's Bizarre Adventure on Netflix and immediately looked to Roblox to find a game based on the mediocre anime that they now believe is the best thing that's ever existed. You will often find the noob sitting in public servers asking to see stats, despite being able to see stats through a simple command, or attempting to trade you despite not even having a stand. Eventually, you will either move on to stage 2, or you will forever be stuck in the hell that is stage 1, forever asking to trade or see stats, and never making any progress. Stage 2 is the noob with initiative. The noob finally starts to grind out levels and get some cash of their own so they can start getting stands. However, leveling is still very slow despite a lot of updates designed to improve this early stage of the game. So at this point, a lot of people will actually quit the game, avoiding the hell that is further ahead in later stages. Though, after the noob with initiative has gained some cash, they will move to the end of stage 2, where they start to spend the cash, and this leads directly to stage 3. Now, either the noob will realize that the RNG is terrible and immediately quit the game, or they will discover that they are actually a gambling addict and will be unable to leave the game from this point. There is no in-between, there is no casual enjoyment of the game, you are either addicted or you're gone. Stage 3 consists of the player, who I will no longer call a noob because they are a fellow gambling addict, constantly rolling stands, getting cash, rolling stands, in an endless loop until they get something that is slightly somewhat usable that isn't complete and utter garbage. This is the point where they enter stage 4, which is the realization that they are at the bottom of the food chain. Now that the player has obtained something that isn't absolute garbage, they believe that they can get anything they want, including a giveaway stand, one of the stands with a fancy gold star. And so you will often see them in trade chat in the Stands Online Discord saying LF giveaway, which means they are looking for a giveaway in exchange for their stand. And as you can see on screen, the accompanying stand is less than desirable, let alone for a giveaway stand. But this is also another point in the path where different players either get stuck here or move ahead to later stages. Some people never accept that their stands are terrible and they can't get a giveaway, so they will continue to offer until the end of time. While others progress to stage 5, having realized that they are at the bottom of the food chain. Stage 5 is where they stop rolling stands and get serious and start trading. They trade their mediocre stand for slightly better mediocre stands, and slowly work their way up the tier list until getting a quote-unquote high-tier stand. At this point, the player will attempt to get another high-tier stand through a series of trades so that they can multi for a giveaway, and this is the point where they enter stage 6. Having finally traded for a fancy gold star giveaway stand, the player will not feel accomplished. They will realize this is not the joy that they were seeking out for the past 6 months, and will continue to hunt more giveaways, seeking out the dopamine rush that the first giveaway they obtained did not give them. They will stay stuck in stage 6, or they will eventually achieve stage 7, which is the realization that this is a waste of time, and the player will stop hunting giveaways, and they will finally move on to something actually productive. So be warned, if you have not yet realized that you are a gambling addict, leave while you can. Otherwise, you'll be subjected to the 10 same JoJo jokes, or you will deal with people with 2 IQ, offering massive underpay for your stands, but regardless, you will be a disappointment being a teenager playing Roblox. But that's all the time we have for today, so hopefully this short video did a good job warning you of the dangers of Stands Online. But until next time, I'm Shineryn, thanks for watching.